like that are humble, and those that are what? Those that are really open, and those that are really poor in spirit. And that's what fasting does. But what happened in the illustration that we gave Wednesday night was that after they fasted and prayed, and Jehoshaphat prayed a very powerful prayer. And this is the importance of praying the word. Jehoshaphat said, Lord, you promised this, you promised this, you promised this, you promised this. And here we are. You said, whenever we would offer these prayers and come before this house, amen, when we're confronted with all of these adversities that we are now encountering, he said you would hear, you would hear, and you would help. Amen. So Jehoshaphat put the word back on God. Lord, this is what you said. I like that. All right, now, the other thing is that when Jehoshaphat prayed that prayer, the Spirit of God began to move. Yes. Evidently, they began to start praising God. Yes. And the Spirit of God began to move through a prophet, and they gave a prophecy and said, God is in this.
Yes.
Amen. Don't fear, y'all. God got your backs. Amen. You don't have to fight in this battle. This battle, God is going to what? He's going to do the fighting, but you got to do the praising. All right, from that point on, all of the commands were worship, praise the Lord in the beauty of holiness, give God thanks. Now, this was all done after they had prayed, after they got a word from God, after they had fasted and all of that. But the thing that brought the battle, amen, into victory, the thing that brought victory in the battle was the fact that Jehoshaphat got down on his knees and he began to worship the Lord. That's before God had done anything. All they had was, you don't have to fight, stand still. God's going to intervene. Amen. Praise God. Just believe in your prophet, so shall you prosper. Amen. Believe in the Lord and everything is going to be all right. So the king got down on his knees and all the Levites got down and started worshiping. Worship it. Amen. Wouldn't it be good if half of us would ever got down?
Glory to God.
I didn't get no emails, no. Amen. If I fell down on this knee, I'm on the floor here and began to cry and weep and roll, amen, y'all would say, Pastor Hill, he, amen, Sister Hill, what have you done to it? Man, I've been so drunk up here sometime and my knees been shaking. I remember sometimes the deacons have to hold me up.
Yes.
Sometimes I've been on the floor for a long time. Worshiping. God loves worship. So y'all understand that. Amen. Praise God. God loves what? Worship. He loves worship. And anybody that's really given to worship, you got to what? Lose sight on yourself. You can't look around, Sister Sherilyn. Amen, praise God, and watch her. See, she's looking. Amen, amen, praise God, because you have to what? David said, bless the Lord, oh my soul, and what? All, everybody say all. See, God wants what? All, 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 all. Now, somebody get that scripture, Ephesians 5:18. It says that we need to what? Amen, be filled. See, the thing that brought victory for Jehoshaphat, the king and the Levites started worshiping. And then they were commanded to go out, the singers were commanded to go out and say, praise the Lord for his mercy endureth forever. Praise the Lord for his mercy endureth forever. Praise the Lord. If I told half of us, that would bring you a miracle if you did it 21 times.
Yeah.
You know what happened? Some said, praise the Lord. His mercy and the Lord. Praise the Lord. See, the praise and thanksgiving is designed to help you, because how in the world can you come to the reality that something as simple as that can bring the results that they got. You can't figure that out in your head. It's going to go against your what? Your psychic every time. And that's called doubt. It's hard to get rid of it. It's hard to penetrate the anointing and get the results that you need when there's what? Doubt and unbelief. But God has given us a way to what? To get rid of everything that hinders and stands in the path of the miracle that He's trying to what? He's trying to release into your life. And how do you do it? Open your mouth. And the Bible says those Levites and priests opened their mouth and shouted real loud. Amen. Amen. Other night we asked who could shout loud. Most people can't shout loud. They do everything they do softly. Some people say, well, God ain't deaf. You ain't got the hollow. Another thing, God ain't what? He ain't nervous either. The walls of Jericho, they fell flat. They went around and they shouted with a what? Great! And when they shouted with a loud voice, and the singers were placed on the front line, and they went forth singing, praise the Lord! His mercy endures forever! Praise the Lord! His mercy endures forever! Praise the Lord! So I'm saying, I don't see how that could do anything. That's the reason you need to praise the Lord, so you can get past your what? Your pea brain. Understand, every obstacle that you have that's going to hinder your faith can be removed by praise. That's the reason why Sister Wayne's in there. There's a raise in praise. Somebody said prayer takes the request to heaven, but it takes what? Praise to bring the answer about that. Because there's a whole lot of stuff that has to be overcome. Amen. And as you begin to what? Praise, the scripture says if you delight yourself in the Lord, He will give you the desires of your heart. The Bible says, blessed is the man that delighteth greatly. Woo, Lord Jesus, Lord Jesus. Blessed is the man that delighteth what? Greatly. Amen. It's hard to get a greatly quality of delight. It's hard to get up greatly. Amen. Lift your hands and bless the Lord.
Bless the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
His mercy endures forever.
His mercy endures forever.
His mercy endures forever.
His mercy endures forever.
All right. Well, we're just going to say it the way we want to say it anyway. So we'll move on. Okay, give me that scripture. Ephesians 5:18. Okay, be not drunk with wine. Wherein is excess, but be what? All right, be filled with the Spirit. Okay. All right, so the type of being filled that we refer to here would be likened until the exuberance, the excitement, or the jubilation that you would have at a football game when your team is winning. Amen. Now, we go to football games, and especially when our grandsons are playing. And boy, when last year I was there, we were there when they won both championships, Dak's team and Justice's team. And they were, the key players. And they make them long touchdowns. Sometimes they do 2, 3, and 4 touchdowns per game. Amen. That's one time that Grandpa gets I get some energy from somewhere. I don't care how tired I am. I don't care how hot I am. Amen. So I'm filled with what? The exuberance and the excitement, I'm filled with it. And it exudes by what? I demonstrate my exuberance by what? Shouting it out loud. Amen. And the Bible says that we need to be what? Filled. Okay, then what else did it say? Going down to the next one. It says, speaking to yourselves in psalms and hymns. In spiritual songs, in psalms and what?
Hymns.
And what? Singing and what? Okay, now, here's the thing. Here's how you get filled. It was Monday night. We were in prayer meeting, and Brother Travis just leaves it open. We just float in the Spirit for about 30 minutes, sometimes 45 minutes. And then the Spirit of singing came in. Yeah. No more run for star risiki shika hori mini shi laroni. We just start singing, and after a while, about five or seven or eight minutes, the anointing began to rise. See, that's the thing that's designed to get you in the Spirit quicker than anything else. Singing. Making melody. How many of you heard of a melody? How many can make one? How many refuse to make one? How many is hard for you to make one? How many don't know how to make one? All right, open your mouth. I'll come and get work with you now, right quick. Now, this is the key. Now, y'all heard what almost happened here this morning. I heard what almost, that was the little bit that we got. That was pretty good, wasn't it? But what could have happened if half of y'all would have gotten up and started singing in the Spirit? See, many of us feel like, well, I don't know whether we're supposed to do that or not. How long does anybody do nothing like that? I ain't going to get up and sing something. I don't know what I'm saying. And the Scripture plainly says what? Be filled. And it tells you what you got to do to what? Get filled. Now, this is God's will for all believers to what? Praise Him with what? Melody in your heart. Otherwise, your prayer is going to be what? Cut and dry. It's going to be the same all the time. That means what? You will stay at the same level all the time. Because you're not being what? Humble. You're not seeing. Humility means that, amen, not believing, a pride is believing lies about yourself. Believe that you don't have to do none of this. You don't have to get emotional. You don't have to raise your voice. You ain't got to what? Pray in the Spirit. You can just be cold and dead. Amen. Boy, about 30 minutes of that, brother. Amen. It seemed like we've been there. I mean, the anointing was just so sweet and so good. Amen. I can tell when Sister Coleman, praise God, I can tell when things begin to happen. Amen. When she gets released, the prayer has taken hold. I mean, it has worked. When she gets that release, you know it. Praise God, something has happened in that prayer meeting. So everybody in the room almost just went up. Amen. After a while, praise God, when the anointing lifted, amen, we said, Brother Travis said, I got a testimony. Yes. Amen. I got a testimony. Amen. Praise God. I thought Brother Travis was going to say, well, amen, the Lord just made a way. Got $10,000 in mail. I didn't know what, but God made some need. Hey, Brother Travis got to sit up and say, amen, I thank God for this water. That was cool. Because I'm doing everything I can to get y'all at a point where what? Your physical body can what? Actually what? Hang it long enough so that you can what? Really begin to experience what? The power and the anointing of God. And everybody in the meetings of the Mary talked about the water. So I'm glad, because maybe the water can give them some energy. It's going to take eating right, exercise, amen, vitamins. It's going to take all of that, praise, and a whole lot of water to give you some energy. Because, amen, many times people don't worship the Lord because they don't feel like it. Is that right? Amen. All right, praise God. So, this is what God wants us to do, saints. And as long as we are doing it in the power of our own strength, doing it our own way, without a real hunger, without a real motivation, without a real desire. Amen. Amen. The Scripture says it's the effectual, what? Fervent.
Yes, glory to God.
Amen.